Hello everyone, Shinto Bean here with some more Warhammer Combat cards. I hope you are all enjoying the holidays. Here we are looking in the shop. There's a Christmas booster pack. There's actually a free one earlier. In the days leading up to Christmas this past week, they've been giving out free packs of 40 cards for each faction. Different one every day, so that's been pretty nice. They've also got the Red Gabo. This is a new one. There's actually another version of the Red Gabo, but this one is mounted on a squig. The Bouncin' Revolution, he's actually the only orc with regeneration, so funky little card there. And that one you do have to pay for. So, for this match, we are going to be playing in the campaign. It's just a regular campaign. I haven't done one of these matches in quite a while, but the Swarmlord is actually coming up on its one-year anniversary. It was released on January 1st, 2021, and a year later I have it at level 5. I really haven't been using it very much because it's just in my opinion, not the most interesting warlord to play as, but it does have pretty good stats here at level 5, so we'll see if it can pull its weight in the campaign. Running a pretty standard psychic build here, and yeah, I'm interested to see how this goes. Up against the level 25 AI, go ahead and start this battle. This week, there haven't been any special campaigns yet, but I believe, yeah, next week there will be a new Chaos Warlord coming out. I'm assuming with the next campaign, because it is a Chaos campaign. We're up against Ahriman. I've already stated my opinions on Tyranids. I think Tyranids' Psykers really kind of struggle against the Psykers of other factions, because they don't have any warlords that can really improve their damage output. But we'll see how this goes, Ahriman. Of course, in the campaign, they have a mix of units. And right off the bat, they have this Executioner with Fear. And Fear at the higher levels is not fun to deal with. So we're going to be taking a lot of damage here and not be able to deal much in return, I think. The enemy does have the initiative as well. So they'll be able to go for a ranged attack, I think, for plenty of damage, debuffing my melee as well. So that is also kind of unfortunate. With the Swarmlord, if you're going with a psychic build, you want to, you know, obviously go with the psychic attacks each turn, but then you'll be building up a melee attack that you can use at the end of the game, but that's not going to work out so well if the enemy is just debuffing you in the entire game. So the Master of Executions with Fear, he's going to be lasting for quite some time, so I think they'll be able to get some good mileage out of these cards. Again, with the Swarmlord special ability, debuffing the enemy by 15% at the end of each enemy turn, as you can see right there. And there goes the Zone Throat, getting blasted away by the Bolt of Change at the beginning of the turn, which means I get one less attack this turn. It's not going so great for the Tyranid so far. I really do not want to get my Maliceptor poisoned by that Plague Marine, that's why I deployed it in the middle. Oh, but there's lots of poison coming to the field here, and well, something's going to have to get poisoned. And I'm thinking, well, I guess we'll just go with put some poison of our own on the field. This guy actually has pretty good damage output, 95 damage, but even with at the level he's at, he's not going to survive for a huge amount of time. The Maliceptor also does not really have the best damage output at this level, and especially with the Fear, it's only dealing 27 damage. Alright, so we've got, I guess we'll go with the Neurothrope over in the left lane. That thing also has pretty good damage. And we'll be able to take down the Plague Marine. But this poison is pretty painful. And they've got a pretty big melee attack charged up as well. Chaos, of course, have a lot of melee fighters, so once they decide to go for the melee, it's going to be a lot of damage. And here they've got the Fiend of Slaanesh, and here comes that melee attack. So 101 damage from the Master of Executions, 89 from the Fiend hitting the Maliceptor. That's a whole lot of damage, and we're really not doing very well here, are we? Debuffing the melee there. I think we have to deploy the Swarmlord at this point. So they still have two more bodyguards after these three die. So, it's really not going so great, even with the enemy's lack of psychic on the field. Moving the Maliceptor to the right lane, Swarmlord does have pretty good psychic attack, but again, with the fear, it's getting reduced to very low amounts of damage. And they can go for the ranged attack unopposed. Which is what they're doing. Once again, debuffing the melee twice this time. So, yeah, I have not been able to charge up that melee attack whatsoever. However, the Swarmlord is quite strong. Again, its stats are pretty crazy, so... as long as they don't really use much AoE, then they're really not going to be able to get through the amount of health that the Swarmlord has. It still has all three of its shields. So we're going for the Psychic Attack and actually able to finally kill something this turn. Two of their units go down. So the final two bodyguards will be deploying this turn. And, oh, that's a lot of melee right there. Okay, we got this guy, the Aspiring Champion. 75 melee attack, that's huge. So down goes the Neurothrope. The Maliceptor survives, fortunately. That's going to be pretty big, actually. Sonic Blast, I think, will have barely enough damage to take out the Fiend. And let's go for some healing. Try to keep that thing alive, actually, but I think the Bloodthirster is just going to finish it off next turn. 20 damage from that Bolt of Change. So yeah, we're not going to have enough to take out the Bloodthirster, of course, but... Fortunately, the Swarmlord actually has the right attack types to do battle against Ahriman. And Ahriman does not have a whole lot of health. I mean, he's at level 4, but he's not going to stand much of a chance here. They're going Psychic. 126 Psychic damage. See, the AI is really not very smart when it comes to dealing with shields. That was a very foolish move on their part. Getting hit by the Swarmlord's Psychic counterattack, but... I still don't have quite enough damage, I don't think. 4 damage short of killing Ahriman with the melee attack, so we're just gonna go... Well... Someone has one shield left. Deathblow is gonna go off if the Bloodthirster dies. But, yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So... Gonna kill that Bloodthirster. Here comes the Deathblow, killing the... Maliceptor removing the last shield, 61 damage to the Swarmlord from that psychic attack, and now we can just bring this little Gene Stealer in. Finally get a little bit of a melee buff here from the Scout. And then we'll be able to finish off Ahriman next turn. They're actually going psychic. Okay, so he is down to 11 health. And it took quite a while to get to the end of the game here, but finally, Swarmlord is going to be able to do some chopping action, 161 damage, and cutting down Ahriman for the victory. But yeah, those, the Tyranid Psykers, they did not do so well in this battle. Those bodyguards, I mean, they got killed pretty easily by those Chaos. And Chaos bodyguards actually tend to have slightly higher stats, I think, for their cost than those of other factions, at least it seems that way. So yeah, I mean, I have plenty of ideas for, you know, how to make Tyranids better, but I'm going to refrain from going into that for now. But yeah, let me know what you think of this Swarmlord, now that it's been out for a year, if you actually use it in ranked mode. Be curious to see how it's performing these days. But that's it for this one. Keep an eye out for the videos covering the new content that is coming out next week, though. And I will see you next time.